for general use, no? So yung mga equipment, yung mga electrical equipment na kadalasan nating ginagamit, no? Ginagamit in electrical installation or electrical operations, no? So ang una diyan is kasama sa mga equipment, kino-consider din ng chapter 4 is yung flexible cord or cable. So nandito yung demand factor, no, for more than 3 current carrying conductor in a flexible cord or cable, no. So if that is 1 to 3, so yung demand factor mo is 100% or the adjustment factor is 100%, but more than 3, so dito na tayo, no, from 4 to 6 that will be 80%, 7 to 9 that will be 74%. So 10 to 20, that will be 50%. So 21 to 30, 45. 31 to 40, that will be 40%. No? At 41 and above, that will be 35. So kunyari, meron kang 10, no? 10 na flexible cord in a single conduit, no? So nilagay mo doon. So you must consider the rating factor or the adjustment factor. So yung 10, yung kanyang demand factor will just be only 50%. So therefore, we will consider na yung nakikiri na current doon is only 50% of its original ampacity. So yan yung ibig sabihin ng demand factor, adjustment factor ng flexible cord or cable. Okay, so you have the type of fixture wires. So these are all wires used for small equipments, no? So katulad nung ginagamit natin sa mga ilaw, no, or sa mga electronic devices. So ito yung tanging fixture wires, no. So we have here the type, no, or the trade name. So kunya ito, heat resistant rubber covered fixture wire flexible stranding. So ang kanyang type letter is FFH-2. So yung operating temperature niya is 75 degrees Celsius, no. So lahat nandito yan, no. So this is not part of the usual one. Yung alam natin na THHN, THW, no, XHW, no, because those are conductors. So ito fixtures wire. So maliliit to siya na wire. So kaya tayo merong sizes, no? Sizes, allowable ampacity of fixture or luminaire wire, no, yung ginagamit natin sa mga ilaw, no, or sa mga lighting assembly. So we have for the smallest size, no, is 0.75 square mm or 1.0 diameter, no. The allowable ampacity for that one is 6 amperes, no. Tapos yung 5.5, that is 2.6, so that is 28 amperes. So ito pinakamaliit na size ng fixture wires according to the Philippine Electrical Code is 0.75 square mm. Ang pinakamalaki is 5.5 square mm. Okay. So yun, no, the fixture wire shall not be smaller, no. So hindi siya pwedeng mas maliit pa kaysa 0.5 square mm or 1.2 mm diameter. So the marking, no, the marking on our fixture wire, so the thermoplastic insulated fixture luminaire wire shall be marked on the surface at intervals not exceeding 600 mm. So katulad nung mga doon sa chapter 3 natin kung saan yung wiring, approved wiring methods, no, and wiring materials, so nakalagay din yung marking, no. So sa iba, that is yung kaniyang size is at every 600 mm, habang yung kaniyang brand naman is every 100 mm na interval, no. So dito yung ating fixture wires, so yung marking niya is in interval not exceeding 600 mm. So all other fixtures shall be marked by means of printed tag attached to the coil and the reel, no? Or the reel, no. So yung if ever na aside sa loob ng wire mayon siyang marking. So yung kanyang box, nakalagay din doon yung pangalan ng wire pati yung tamang marking na kung saan din siya yung brand, yung size, yung temperature rating. So yun yung nakalagay sa fixture wires, no. Then switches, no. So the location of switches, so the grip of operating handle of the switch or circuit breaker is not more than 1980 mm above floor or working platform, no? So yan yung ano, yan yung standard niya. So na 1980 mm, no? So sa yung ano, yung old na yung first edition ng Philippine Electrical Code, ang nilagay nila PEC 2017, ang nilagay nila is 1980. Tapos nagkaroon ng ano, tawag doon is correction, no? So sa correction, ang nangyari nitong 1980, no? So kasi nakabase to kasi doon sa National Electrical Code na kung saan naka-fit, no? So ang kapag yung fit is kinonvert siya into mm, so ito yung magiging ano, magiging equivalent, no? Which is that is 6 feet, no? So ito yung magiging equivalent. So ang ginawa nila doon sa ano, sa bago na ano, na Philippine Electrical Code, no? So kasi nabas yun mga December, tapos pagka 2018 nagkaroon sa ng correction. So isa to sa mga correction. Ang nangyari ito, ang ginawa nito is naging 200 mm to siya, no? 200 mm, no? So that is to para yung ano, yung confusion, kasi isipin natin 20 mm that is 2 cm, no? 2 cm. So ang ginawa na lang 200 mm. So kinuha na lang pati yung ano, 2 cm. So that is the maximum height, no, from the grip. So ano sabihin yung grip, yung mismong handle ng ating switch, no? So not more than 200 mm. So mounting of snap switches, no, surface type, no, shall be mounted on insulating materials that separates the conductor or less 3 mm from the surface of the wire cover. So dapat yung ano, yung thickness, no, yung thickness ng mismong switch natin is at least, no, so not less than 13 mm. In the back, if box mounted, so flush type snap switches shall be mounted in boxes installed so that the extension plaster ears are seated against the surface. So naka-flush siya, so yung kanyang gang is nandun siya sa surface, hindi kasama yung gang na ano, na nilagay sa ano, sa semento, or naka-imbed sa semento. Yung gang is nakapatong lang sa surface ng ating ano, ating wall, no? So kaya tinatawag siyang flush. Okay, isolating switches, no? So isolating switches, ang kaniyang rating is 1200 amperes at 250 volts or less, and at over 600 amperes, so at 251 volts to 600 volts, no? So yan yung kanyang rating. So if we have a isolating switch, so we are allowed to have an isolating switch up to 1200 amperes if 250 volts and lower, no? If higher than that, so ang ating pwedeng i-ano lang is 600 amperes for our isolating switches. So yan yung kanyang ano, acceptable rating. If we have to interrupt, no, the interrupting current, so 1200 amperes, same pa rin siya katulad ng sa isolating switch, at 250 volts or less, or over 600 amperes at 251 volts to 600 volts. Okay, so the rating and use of snap switches, no? So for alternating current general use, so ito 'yon, no? So yung usual natin na ginagamit na switch, so we have resistive and inductive loads, tungsten filament lamp, motor loads, no? So the ampere rating of our switch is not to exceed 80%, no? Alternating current, DC current, general use, no? So if that is dual purpose, no? So pwede siya sa resistive load, inductive load, so yung mga common natin na mga light, no? So if that is DC, that's dapat hindi siya exceeding 115 volts, no? Okay? Then we have the copper slash ALR snap switches. So, ang rating niya is 20 ampere or less, which is directly connected to the aluminum conductor. Tapos, may dimmer din tayo. So, yung dimmer, it shall be used only to control permanently installed incandescent luminaires, no? So, dapat yung kapag gumamit ng dimmer, yung ating ilaw is permanently installed, so not for temporary lighting, no? Then we'll go to receptacles, cord connectors, and attachment plugs or caps, no? So yung receptacle natin shall be rated not less than 15 amperes if 125 volts or 15 amperes to 50 volt, and shall be of type not suitable for use as lamp holders, no? So kapag yung ating receptacle is for example, it is a receptacle outlet, so yung rating niya must not be less than 15 amperes. So if that is, if you have a receptacle for aluminum conductors, no, so it shall be rated 20 amperes or less and designed for direct connection of aluminum conductor and shall be marked with copper CO/ALR, no. Then receptacle mounting, so kung paano natin mina-mount yung receptacle. So boxes that are set back, so the mount or the mounting yoke or strap is held rigidly at the finished surface, no. If that is flush, so it must be held at also, no, sa rigid siya, so it is fixed rigidly in sa at the finished surface, no. If that is mounted on covers, so dapat it is held by one or more screw or by a device assembly. If it is a position of put in a position of a receptacle faces, so dapat yung meron siyang projection na yung minimum is 0.38 mm from metal, no. So galing sa kanyang ano metal face plate. So meron siyang minimum na flashing or naka-projection, naka no, nakalagpas siya ng 0.38 mm. Then if the receptacle is installed in countertop, shall not be installed in a face up position. So hindi siya naka face up. So yung face up doon is ang mangyayari kasi kapag face up, ang mangyayari maaaring yung receptacle natin is malagyan ng tubig, no? Kasi countertop usually we will wash the dishes or doon tayo magluluto. So if naka-face up yung ating receptacle sa countertop, so maaaring mabasa at magkaroon ng short, no? Exposed terminals, no? Enclosed so that live wiring terminals are not exposed to contact. So this is usually done if yung ating mga receptacle are outside, no? Meron na weatherproof receptacle, so talagang meron niyang takip, no? Tapos yung mga floor outlets, no, or floor receptacle outlets, so meron din yung mga takip. So that is if our terminals are exposed, so kailangan siyang may cover. That is to avoid expose or that is to avoid indirect contact or being grounded or short circuited. Then the receptacle face plate or yung ano gang plate natin, no, cover plates. So the thickness, if that is metal, no, so ferrous metal, so ibig sabihin doon yung metal na maaring kalawangin, so kaya siya ferrous, no, that is ferrous from the word iron, no. So 0.75 mm ang yung kanyang thickness, habang if non-ferrous metal, no, like stainless or aluminum, so that is 1.00 millimeter thick, no. Yung grounding, so the metal face plate shall be grounded. So kapag metal yung ano mo face plate o yung ano cover plate mo na ginamit sa outlet, so dapat naka-ground yun, no, grounded. So face plate on insulating material, so shall be non-combustible, not less than 0.25 mm thick, permitted to be less than 0.25 mm thick if form or reinforced to provide adequate mechanical strength, no. So dapat yung ating face plate na insulating material, kunyari plastic siya, so yung kanyang property dapat non-combustible, so hindi siya nasusunog, no, or hindi siya pwedeng magpagmula ng apoy, no. So siguro kapag in case if there is a short circuit, so ang mangyayari is matutunaw lang siya, but it will not cause fire, no. Tapos ang kanyang thickness, so dapat not less than 0.25 mm. So switchboards and panel boards, no, so support and arrangement of busbars and conductors, so overheating and inductive effects shall be avoided. So yan yung pinakauna. If we have a busbar inside our conductor and our switchboards or panel board, so dapat it is properly sized to prevent overload, kasi yung nagkukos na yung ano natin, yung conductor natin is ano, nag-iinit, no. Tapos inductive effects, so dapat it is, if it is not in an insulated na ano na bus bar or conductor, so dapat it is properly spaced para hindi magkaroon ng inductive effect, no? So kaya meron tayong tinatawag na ano na clearance, no? Clearance to live parts. So yun, na-discuss natin yung dati yung table na yun, no? So ganun din yun siya, yun din yung susundin. Then shall be installed with a main banding if used as service equipment. So dapat naka-banding siya sa ano natin, sa system natin, sa grounding system. Then, tapos the phase arrangement of the bus bar, so kapag 3-phase, so ang kanyang arrangement is A, B, C, no? Kasi in 3-phase meron tayong dalawang ano phase sequence, ABC tapos CBA. So sa Philippine Electrical Code, dapat yung phase arrangement ating 3-phase bus bars are A, B, C, no? So switchboard, so the clearance from the ceiling shall not be less than 900 mm. So yung kanyang top noon, yung clearance niya from our from the ceiling is not less than, no? Hindi bababa ng 900 mm or 90 cm. Then the location, no, switchboard shall be, so dapat may S dito, shall be located in permanently dry location and then where competent supervision and accessible to only licensed electrical practitioner, no? So the switchboard, the switch gear can only be accessed, no, by a licensed electrical practitioner. So yan yung nakalagay dyan. So if ever there is a trouble on a switch gear or a switchboard, ang pwedeng tumingin lang doon is a licensed electrical practitioner. So hindi pwede yung ano lang, yung electrician lang, no, walang license. So dapat according to the code, that will be the duty na mag-access noon is the licensed electrical practitioner. Okay. So panel board, so classification of panel board. So meron tayong dalawa, no? Dalawang main type of panel board, no, according to Philippine Electrical Code. So una is lighting and appliance brand circuit panel board. So yung kaniyang overcurrent protection, so shall have overcurrent protection of 30 amperes or less, no? So yan yung kanya matatawag natin na maximum, no, per branch niya is 30 amperes or less, no? Shall not have more than 10% of its overcurrent devices protecting lighting and appliance circuit, no? Shall have more than, so yung kanyang branch circuit, so kunyari meron tayong 10, no? Kunyari meron tayong 10. So ang kanyang mga breakers noon is more than 10%, so ibig sabihin from 2 to 10. So ang kanyang pwede protect are the lighting and the small appliances or the branch circuit, no? Kaya ang matatawag natin diyan, that is a lighting and appliance circuit, no? Tapos power panel boards, no? So ito yung power panel, shall have 10% or fewer overcurrent devices protecting lighting and appliance branch circuit. So kailangan natawag natin yung isang panel board na power panel board if it is especially protecting electrical equipment. So yung mga aircon, so at least dalawang circuit lang yung ilaw, so kaya tinatawag natin yung power panel board. But if the lighting or if the panel board, ang kanyang pinoprotect lang talaga is the small appliances circuit, no, branch circuit, so yung mga convenience outlet na mga circuit, tapos ang kanyang iba pang pinoprotect is the light, so that will belong only to lighting and appliance brand circuit panel board. If meron ng electrical equipment, so aircon, heater, range, no, dryer, so tinatawag na yan na power panel board. Okay. So the number of devices in one panel board. So ito. So ilan yung maximum number of breaker na pwede mong ilagay sa panel board, no? If single pole siya, no, single pole na breaker ang ilalagay mo, it shall not have, ang isang panel board dapat ang kanyang number of breakers is not more than 42 breakers or 42 overcurrent devices. So yung maximum number sa panel board na single pole yung ilalagay na breaker is only 42. If 2 pole, so yung 42, i-divide mo ng 2, so that will be 21. No? So, 21 lang na 2 pole na breaker. If 3 poles, so yung 42, i-divide mo ng 3, that will be 14. So, 14 lang na breaker yung pwedeng ilagay mo sa ano, sa panel board, no? 14 na 3 pole breaker. Okay. Then over current protection, so lightning and appliance band circuit panel board individually protected. So it shall be individually protected on the supply side by not more than 2 main circuit breakers or 2 sets of fuses, no? So yung main natin, so it must be at least no, not more than 2, no? So kaya ginagamit usually is isa lang yung main, no? But if your system, so kunyari yung panel board mo is yung kanyang entrance is medyo malayo-layo, so it is also advisable to have a separate ECB, that is enclosed circuit breaker, na same na rating sa main to disconnect the system and ever in case na yung in between na service entrance nun is magkaroon tayo ng trouble, no? Short circuit or overload. So may dalawa kang way to disconnect the switch. So either you will disconnect it on the main panel itself or doon sa ating enclosed circuit breaker. Okay, power panel boards protection, no, shall be protected of a overcurrent device which is not greater than the size of the protection of the panel board, no. So kailangan yung main mo is properly sized siya, no, hindi siya greater than the size of the protection of the main panel board. So kunyari yung main mo is 60 amperes tapos meron kang brand circuit doon na 100 amperes, no. So yung brand circuit mo that is supplying an aircon, so that is not acceptable, no? Kasi nagkakaroon kasi that ganyan na cases, no? Lalo na during the design, no? The design of the system or the protection system sa ating ano, sa ating kinocompute na ano, dwelling unit or ano pa dyan, electrical system. If we are going to apply the proper demand factor, no? Ngayari dyan is mas malaki pa yung isang brand circuit kaysa main, lalo na if that brand circuit ang kanyang sinusupplyan is a non-continuous load, so nakakaroon niya ng ano, ng demand factor, no. But we will always consider the na yung ating yung sa isang panel board yung pinakamalaking breaker na makikita dyan is the main, no, hindi yung breaker na nandoon sa branch circuit. So yung main breaker yung pinakamalaki na rating, no. Stamp switches rated at 30 amperes or less shall have an overcurrent protection of 200 amperes or less, no. Supplied through a transformer, so shall have an overcurrent protection on the secondary side of the transformer. So meron tayong ano protection on the secondary side also of the transformer. Then delta breakers, no, shall not be installed in the panel board. So if your breakers are rated delta, so that is usually installed on the substation itself or the mini substation. Then backfeed devices shall be secured in place by an additional fastener, no. Then panel, so made of moisture resistant non-combustible material. So ibig sabihin yun, yung panel natin is talagang ano siya, moisture resistant at hindi rin siya nasusunog. Tapos yung bus bar, insulated or bare bus bar shall be rigidly mounted. So yung bus bar sa loob ng ating panel board dapat hindi siya nagba-vibrate, no? Kaya kailangan siya naka-rigidly mounted. And protection of instrument circuits, so instrument, pilot lights, potential transformers or other switchboard devices with potential coil shall be protected at 15 amperes or less, no? So yung ating mga instrumentation equipment, so like the voltmeters, the pilot lights, no? So yung maliliit natin na potential transformers or the current transformers, so ang kanyang protection ng kanyang mga coils, no? So that in case of a short circuit, so it is at 15 amperes yung maximum niya or less. Then we have industrial control panel. So this is what we call sometimes as the MCC, no? The motor control panel, but the proper terminology po that is industrial control panel, kasi yung MCC naman hindi lang talaga nakalagay doon is for the motors, no? So meron ding ibang ano doon, meron ding ibang mga devices for other purposes other than controlling the motor itself, no? So an assembly of systematic standard arrangement of two or more component such as motor controllers, overload relays, fuse disconnect switches and circuit breakers, and related control devices such as push buttons, station selector switches, timers, switches, control relays and the like with associated terminal blocks, pilot and similar components. So the industrial control panel does not include the controlled equipment, no? Then the minimum size and opacity. So industrial control panel shall be rated at 125% of the full load current. So yung kanyang ano, yung kanyang mismong main contact ng ating industrial control panel, kunyari sa contactor natin yan. So yung main niya na contact is, ang rating niya is shall be rated 120% of the full load rating kung ano yung ating kinokontrol. Kung yung motor, so dapat 125% of the full load current of the motor. Then luminaires or lighting fixtures, lamp holders and lamp, no? So yung luminaire natin for specific locations. So we have wet and damp location, no? Shall be made so that water cannot enter. Then for corrosive location shall be a type suitable for such location, so yung hindi siya nagre-react into sa mga chemical na pwede present sa ano sa ating location, no? Then inducts or hoods, so the temperature limits in the area shall be not exceeded, no? So we'll consider if nasa ilalim ng ducting natin, so we will consider the temperature rating of our luminaires. So bathtub and shower areas, no? So no lighting fixture, cord suspended luminaires, light tracks, pendants or ceiling suspended fans within 900 mm horizontal and 2400 mm vertically from the top of the bathtub brim or shower stall threshold. So wala talagang naka-install, no, na mga suspended lights na malapit doon sa bathtub, no. So that is to take away yun, no, yung possibility na baka magkaroon ng accidental, so mahulog yung bigla yung ating lighting fixture na kasi kadalasan yung, kasi if you consider this height, no, 2400, ang kadalasan ginagawa diyan is yung ating ilaw, no, that is to give accent, no, to the bathtub or to the bathroom. So kailangan ginagawa niya is naglalagay niyang parang ano, parang nakahang din siya, no. So in case na yun maputol, then it will cause mahulog sa aning bathtub. So mangyari yung naliligo doon baka makuryente, no. So that's why it is not advisable. So meron lang tayong 900 mm. So this is the maximum horizontal distance and 2400 vertical distance, no. Okay, then we have luminaires, no, or near or over combustible materials, no. So dapat yung ating luminaire can withstand an excess of 90 degrees Celsius, tapos yung kanyang height, no, from above the floor is not less than 2400 mm and it shall be guarded, no. So kung meron, pwede siyang lagyan ng ano, ng tawag doon, fencing, no, or lagyan niya siya ng sa isang sidlan, that is to avoid damage to our lamps. Okay, no. So luminaire fixtures in close closet, so ito lang yung mga acceptable, no. So we have the surface recess na incandescent or surface recess fluorescent, then types not permitted, so yung mga incandescent luminaires with open or partially enclosed, no, naka partially enclosed pendant luminaires, lamp holders, no. Clearances permitted for different terminal fixture, no, from the nearest storage space, so ito, so 300 mm 150 mm, no. So the incandescent 300 mm for fluorescent 150, no. So if it is recessed, no, so naka ano siya, naka imbed, no, or naka living siya, so that is 1500 mm for incandescent, 150 mm for incandescent and 150 also for fluorescent, no? Then wirings of luminaires, so dapat yung ating size ng ating conductor. So for Mogul base, no, nakadepende kasi yan sa base ng ating lamp, no? So it shall not be smaller than 200 square mm. So if that is an intermediate or candelabra base lamp holder, so not smaller than the fixture wire, no, which is 0.75 square mm. Twisted or cabled, so longer than 900 mm shall be twisted together. So if you are going to use the fixture wires, so kapag lumagpas na siya ng 900 mm, so that is gagawin natin dapat naka-twist yung ating fixture wire, so that is to give, no, support, no, yung kasi kapag hindi yan naka-twist, so it will cause, pwede ba siyang magsag, so that's why nagawa tini-twist yan siya, no. Then broad circuit conductors and ballast, no, so the broad circuit conductor shall be within 775 mm from the ballast with temperature rating not lower than 90 degrees, no, Celsius. Lighting track, so a lighting track is a manufactured assembly designed to support an energized luminaire, so that are capable of being readily repositioned on the track. So it can be altered by the addition or subtraction of sections of track. Now then the appliances, so the provision for appliances, so the rating of that one shall not be less than 195% of the mark rating for motor operated appliances. So ito yung kanyang rating ng kanyang conductor, and it also shall not be less than 100% of the mark rating rated at continuous loading. And overcurrent protection, no, for household type appliances with surface heating, so the with a maximum demand of more than 6 ampere, so it must have 2 or more circuits for power supply with protection rated not over 50 amperes, no. So infrared lamp commercial heating, so the overcurrent protection shall not exceed 50 amperes. Now for motor operated, single non-motor operated appliances, so shall not exceed, no, the nameplate rating mark on the appliances, no, or shall not exceed 20 ampere rating if the current is 13.3 ampere or less, no. Okay, then the color for our fixed electric heating, so the color of the heating cable, so ito, no, if that is rated at 120 volts, so yellow. Kapag 208 volts, so that will be blue. Tapos kapag red, so that will be 240 volts, no. So brown is 277 volts, tapos 480 volts ang orange, no. Okay, then we have clearance for of wiring in ceiling, so shall not be less than 50 mm above the heated ceiling, no, with an ambient temperature of 50 degrees Celsius. Then we'll go to motors, motor circuit and motor controllers. So meron tayong mga definition dito what is in adjustable speed drive, na makikita rin ito sa definition sa Philippine Electrical Code, chapter 1, no, definition of terms. Tapos motor control circuit, tapos system isolation equipment. Okay, so part winding transformer, so ito yung first na motor control, so started by energizing first its primary armature winding and subsequently the remainder of this winding in one or more steps. So one half of its primary winding can be energized initially, another half follows in one or more steps. So if that is a use in air conditioning, so meron tayong hermetic refrigerant compressor, so shall not be considered a standard part winding or standard induction motor, no. Then the ampacity and the motor rating determination, so general motor application, so motors considered as low speed. Okay, so the motors are considered low speed when their RPM is less than 1200, no. So high speed low torque lower full load current. So low speed, high torque, so higher yung kanyang full load current. So ibig sabihin, pag mabilis yung ikot pero mababa yung torque, so mas mababa ang kanyang full load current, no? If that is low speed tapos mataas yung torque, so the higher yung full load current. Then torque motor, so the rated current shall be the lock rotor current. Now, if that motor is for we consider the torque itself, no, gamit ng anong torque motors, so we will consider the full load current niya or the rated current niya as the lock rotor current. Okay, so marking on motors and multi-motor equipment, so dapat nakikita yung name ng manufacturer, rated voltage and rated full load current, frequency and the number of phases if that is an AC motor, rated full load speed, rated temperaturized, tapos yung time rating, no? So the time rating shall be this one, no? 5, 15, 30 or 60 minutes or continuous. So the rated horsepower, so the minimum horsepower for motors is 1.8, no, as per Philippine technical code, or more, no? So kaya minimum yung ating 1.8. Then the code letter or lock rotor ampere if an alternating current, no? So design letter for design is B, C or D motors. Then secondary volts and volt load current if a wound rotor induction motor. Then field current and voltage for DC excited synchronous motor. Winding, so ano yung kasing winding niya? Thermal protection marking, impedance protected. Tapos motor equipped with electrically powered condensation prevention heater shall be marked with the rated heater voltage, number of phases, and the rated power in watts. So yan yung nakalagay lahat sa nameplate ng motor, no? Or motor equipment. The terminal, so the marking, the terminal shall be marked or colored if necessary, no? So if we need to have the different phases, no, ng terminal, no, so dapat nakamark siya na yung every terminal ng ating motor have different colors. Then the conductor, so the conductor shall be connected with a copper unless otherwise permitted. The torque requirement, no, for the shafting of our motors, no, is 0.8 Newton meter torque for screw type pressure terminals or the conductor is 2.0 square mm, no, 1.6 diameter ng ating terminal. Okay, so single motor, so the selection of the branch circuit conductor. So yung branch circuit conductor ng ating motor shall not be less than 125% of the full load current of the motor. If multi-speed motor, the highest full load current rating shall be the one shown on the motor template, no? So ano yung makikita sa na full load current sa motor template, yan yung pinaka-high na full load current ng ating multi-speed motor, no? Y start delta run motor shall be size at 58%, no, of the full load, no. Yung kanyang conductor o kanyang conductor is 58%. Part winding motor shall be size at 50% for the conductor. Tapos other continuous duty, so conductors for motor use in short time, intermittent, periodic or varying duty application shall have an opacity not less than, no, hindi bababa sa nameplate rating ng ating motor. Then separate terminal enclosure, so conductors between a flat stationary motor rated 1 horsepower or less shall be permitted to be smaller than 2.0 square mm but not smaller than 0.75 square mm or 1.0 mm in diameter. So the rating for continuous duty motors, so when you say continuous duty, so more than 8 hours yung kanyang gamit. So the more than 1 horsepower na rating, so dapat meron siyang if the overload device is separate, so 125% if the service factor is 1.15, 125% if the temperature mark rise is 40 degrees Celsius, all other motors are at 150% yung kanyang conductor. Then thermal protector, so 170% for full load current 9 amperes or less.